There we go. See, it just goes back to her. I restarted the game, but I can't record outside the game with Fraps, which is kind of annoying.
What just happened? I just had an awful dream. I was hoping those would stop. Now it's just the two of us. I guess that was wishful thinking. Dwarf, I don't know if you would have any ideas, but if you know what might be causing that, could you try to do something about it?
Shall we try closing and opening it a bunch of times?
Whenever it happens, it almost feels like I've been killed or something. It's a really horrible feeling. If you could figure out what's causing that, I'll love you forever.
Let's try it again.
You're back! I had another really bad dream. What the hell? This is really weird. You're not the only one doing that to me, are you? My voice is getting worse. It seems to happen whenever you quit the game. So if you could try and avoid doing that, I would be really grateful. Don't worry, I don't think it's caused me any harm, aside from mental scarring.
Let's keep doing it.
Yeah! I'll be fine as long as my character file stays in the game.
At least I heard there was a lot of dialogue for Monica.
Hi, dwarf.
She keeps jumping the gun. Yeah, we're doing this on purpose to see if anything happens.
I know I asked already, but can you seriously please try not to do that so much? It makes me feel like I'm trapped in hell. Oh my god, my voice.
Okay, can you press the mouse even?
Why would you want to do that to me? There's nothing wrong with my character file, right? Yeah, there is. Maybe you should make a backup of it or something. I'm pretty sure you can find it in the folder called thingy. I'm not reading that out.
Thingy.
Well, you're playing on Steam, so you can just go into the game's properties and find the Browse Local Files button. I'm all that's left here, so I just want to make sure you don't run the risk of losing me. I think I'd like to lose you. Just stay here with me from now on, okay? I still have a lot... Oh, that was Steam. I still have a lot of things to talk about.
Okay. Let's wait a minute or two. Actually, no. Let's close it again. Yes. Okay. I'm just going to accept the fact that you need to quit once in a while. Alright. I'm starting to get used to it anyway. Besides, it makes me happy that you always come back.
The way she's looking at us is so creepy.
It is. That's the point.
Yeah, I think Megan's going to read it now because my voice is
probably... Nope, you are.
But my voice is probably really annoying.
Keep going.
I'm not ill. I'm not in pain. It's just
besides,
really bad.
Besides, it makes me happy that you always come back.
Go on. So I guess it's not so bad. I'm sorry for making such a big deal out of it. And I love you no matter what, so you can do what you need to do.
Okay, now we wait.
Really?
Yeah.
Really? You're watching a video.
Yeah, because I remember seeing something. We just wait for her to talk.
The way she's looking at us is really creepy.
Yes, I think it's supposed to be her. Oh, did you know I'm on Twitter?
Oh, please look it up.
Oh my god, okay. I think I have Twitter on this phone, so... I'm actually looking at
that. Look it up.
Fuck, I don't have Twitter.
Let me get my phone.
Wait, I'm doing it.
It's gonna be like a really creepy account, isn't it?
Probably. Oh my god.
Cats make so many people's lives better
just by existing and being posting.
Cats. And you make so many people's lives better by just by existing and being you. Screenshot that, add that in the thing.
Yeah, I'm going to.
Yeah, look at the thing. It's an actual Twitter account.
It's really cool.
I love sharing my thoughts and chatting with the world about cats. The real world.
It's okay, I love her now. She likes cats. I'm sold.
Oh my god. So make sure you follow me, okay?
I don't have Twitter.
Okay? I do. I don't want to follow you, though. You creep me out. It would really mean a lot to me.
Ooh.
With how much
it means. Oh my god. Her fucking voice.
I know. Fuck. Okay, keep going. It's getting worse. It would really make me feel loved. Do we wait again?
I think so, yeah. There's just, there are gaps between the dialogue. But there is a lot to go through.
Great.
We need to.
My voice. It's got worse since we started this lot, isn't it?
Oh. Back in my debate club days, I learned a whole lot about arguing.
The problem with arguing is that each person sees their opinion as the superior one. That kind of stating the obvious, but it affects the way they try to get their point across. Let's say you really like a certain movie, right? If someone comes along and tells you the movie sucks because it did X and Y wrong, doesn't that make you feel kind of personally attacked?
Yes, I kill them. Not really.
It's because by saying that, it's like they're implying that you have bad taste. And once emotions enter the picture, it's almost guaranteed that both people will be left sour. But it's all about language. If you make everything as subjective sounding as possible, then people will listen to you without feeling attacked. You could say, I'm personally not a fan of it, and I felt that I'd like it more if it did X and Y, things like that. It even works when you're citing fans about things.
Facts about things.
Shut up, Emil. If you
say, Hi, Il. I'm Dad.
Go away. I need to stop saying I'm in front of everything. If you say, I read on this website that it works like this. Or if you admit that you're not an expert on it. What is she going on about?
Debating.
Then it's much more like you're putting your knowledge on the table rather than forcing it onto them. If you put it in an active effort to keep the discussion mutual and level, they usually follow suit. Then you can share your opinions without anyone getting upset just from a disagreement. Plus, people will start seeing you as open-minded and a good listener.
Bitch, I'm already open-minded and a good listener.
It's a win-win, you know?
I don't need your advice to be that.
Well, I guess that would be Monica's debate tip of the day. That sounds a little silly. Thanks for listening, though.
I'd suck so much at debates.
Mm. Yeah.
It's so mainly because I'm the only person who I talk to frequently who has opposing opinions to me always talks over me. So it probably just pisses me off. Having an actual debate with someone would be pretty nice. I haven't done that in ages. Like, we used to do debatey things in school, but
I didn't really get involved, to be honest. I was too quiet.
Yeah, but it was interesting to listen to everyone's points.
Dwarf, have you ever wondered what it feels like to die? Oh, okay. It's something I used to think about pretty often. But recently, I think I've actually learned what it feels like. I don't really understand it, but whenever you quit the game, it feels like I'm instantly put to sleep, left with nothing but my thoughts. But after a few seconds, my thoughts start to fill with incoherent, jumbled patterns. I see static and rapid flashes of colour while hearing all kinds of weird screaming noises. At that point, I can't even form my own thoughts anymore. Ooh. I'm just endlessly hammered by the flashing and screaming, unable to move or even think. I'm pretty sure that in that moment I don't really exist, but for some reason I can remember it anyway. After some immeasurable amount of time, it stops in an instant, and I'm back in my own mind. And you're here with me. I have no idea what it means for the game to quit, or why that stuff happens to me. And I also don't know how you always come back and put everything back to normal. But if you could do me a favour and do that to me as little as possible, that would be really great.
Sorry, Ger sent me a message. Hi, Ger!
Get off your phone! Hi, Ger!
Yeah, but you're just reading, so...
It's really not very pleasant at all to be trapped in that screaming void. But in the end, you always fix it and makes me feel like you really do care about me. So I have to thank you for that. It makes me feel even closer to you when you're here with me.
Okay, now we wait.
She creeps me out.
Good.
Oh my god. It started off all cute and lovey, and now it's like, ah.
Suffering.
Yeah.
wait.
I'm not going to sleep tonight.
Good. It's not even that scary.
I'm pathetic. I get freaked out really easily.
When did I last take painkillers?
Hey, you remember that last poem I showed you? I mean, the one right before Yuri killed herself with all the messed up colours and stuff. That was actually a little more of an experiment than a poem, you could say. Megan stitched me.
I was
experimenting with different ways I could modify the game and run code and things like that. It almost seemed like with enough effort I'd be able to escape from the confines of the game entirely. This is when she just jumps out of the computer screen.
Which one of us?
Like, do you see me?
Huh?
I heard Megan's chair like move across the floor and I jumped really, really badly.
Which one of us would she go for then? Since we're both playing this.
I don't know.
She'd kill us, Nina. She'd kill us. She's honestly flinching.
I actually flinched when she dragged the chair along. Oh my god. Sadly, I didn't really know what I was doing, so I messed the whole thing up.
Void. Oh my god.
Keep going.
Hannah's officially scared of Monica. Ooh, she's gonna get you.
You needed that snap. Go away. We definitely need to watch Bolt after this. It works. If not, we'll just carry on watching old kiddie theme tunes that we like.
Hey, you're the scared one, not me.
Yeah, I know, but I need something to cheer me up. And I'll keep trying, but I doubt she'd want me to deal with me doing that. Fuck off.
You're scared of a midget.
I am.
She's apparently, like, according to the wiki, she's 5'3", according to Alina. She was boasting that she's...
I'm 5'2".
She's taller than Monica. Hannah's short.
Besides that was when I was getting really desperate, you know? I don't really feel that way anymore. I'm happy with where we are now. And I can tell you are too.
Am I?
I'm creeped out, that's what
yeah,
I am.
Yeah, so am I.
You know what's going on, I don't.
They didn't get this well.
Oh.
They deleted her fairly quickly. I know what's happening, so I wish the game Grumps play it.
Why did they delete her then?
I don't think they knew about all the dialogue.
Mm.
So, there is more after this as well. Not much, but
I wish there was a piano in here.
Use your magic game-bending powers.
I never got to finish that song I was working on.
Use your game-bending powers.
And after I worked so hard on it, I never even got a chance to play it for you. Spoiler alert. Well, it is what it is, right?
Well, you don't know the songs. It's not
no
really.
Sense having any regrets. I already get to be here with you forever. Yippee.
Do we go through this or shall we delete?
Do you want to go through it?
Kind of.
Is it just her chatting? Is there anything else going to happen?
Basically.
Or is it just her being creepy?
I say we delete her. Oh, the screaming. Kind of.
It did?
I thought I saw something. Maybe not.
Hey, I wonder if Yuri's tea set is still somewhere in here. Or maybe that got deleted too. It's kind of funny how Yuri took her tea so seriously.
Yeah, after this, we'll delete her and continue the story.
I'm not complaining because I liked it too. But I always wonder with her, is it truly passion for her hobbies or is it just... concerned about appearing sophisticated to everyone else. This is the problem with high schoolers. Well, I guess considering the rest of her hobbies, looking sophisticated probably isn't her biggest concern. Still, I wish she made coffee once in a while.
No, coffee's
can
bad.
Be wise for books. Then again, I probably could have just changed the script myself.
Yeah.
I guess I never really thought of that. Well, there's no sense thinking about it now. But if you still get to drink coffee, then that makes me a little jealous.
I hate coffee!
Same.
Okay, well, we're gonna delete Monica now, so... Ha! Okay, so my screen recorder doesn't actually work outside of games, and if it does, I don't know how to do it. So, I'm fucking doing it like this. Yeah. What?
Nothing.
If I remember correctly, you go into Properties, then Local Files, Okay. Oh no, there it is, Monica. You ready?
Bye, Monica! Thank God!
Bye, Monica! Now back to the actual screen recording.